Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create Vray Realistic class, Tinted class, Gradient class, and finally, Textured class. The scene setup is extremely simple. We have some polygon objects in the scene. As far as lighting is concerned, the scene has a dome light for soft lighting and an HDRI as an environment map for reflection mirrors. Realistic glass. Create a basic Vray material and assign it to the glass panel. In your Vray materials, click on Vray MTL material. Next, select the object, right click and assign material to selection. Start interactive rendering. Most of the refractive and transparent material have a very dark diffuse color, so set the diffuse color to black. Plus, if you look at a piece of a glass, you would notice a very strong reflection, so set the reflection color to 230. Dark color means less reflection, while bright color means full reflection. Also, make sure that funnel reflection is checked to get the glass look. Currently, there is no transparency or refraction in the glass panel. To make it refractive, go to the refraction section and change the reflection color to 250. Again, black color means no refraction, while brighter color means more refraction. Next, index of refraction or IOR values for glass type is between 1.5 to 1.7. For glass panel, set it to 1.517. For other IOR values, type IOR values in your browser and see the result from there. Oops, one more thing. Set both the reflection and refraction max depth to 10. Change this max depth to 10 and also this max depth to 10. In 99% of situations, max depth 10 will make sure that you get the perfect reflection and refractions in your renders. If you want to know more about materials, its link is in the description. Now, we have successfully made a clear glass. Next, it's extremely simple to make a tinted glass. We use the fog color to set the color of your glass panel and fog multiplier to control the strength of the fog color. Remember that my glass panel is 2 inch thick, so the result can be different if you have a different panel size, but the concept will be same. Change the fog color according to your need, but I will suggest not to use a fully saturated color. Example: pure red, pure blue. Do not use a fully saturated color, or else you might run into trouble. Let's see an example. Keep a slightly less saturated color. Now, use the fog multiplier to control the strength of the fog color. Values greater than 1 will increase the fog color strength. Change the value from 1 to 5. You can see that the fog color strength is increased. While values lower than 1 will decrease the fog color. 1 less than 1. 0.5, 0.2. That's how we make a realistic tinted glass. You can see it's extremely easy. Since we know how to add color to our glass panels, now it's time to make some creative gradient glass panels. Click on the fog color texture slot and add a gradient map. We can rotate the gradient to add some creativity. You can see red to white, or minus 90, red to white. I can even click here and change this color. Now it's all up to you how creative you are, and you can easily change these values and get some very creative results. Next, textured glass panel. Now, we will learn how to add texture in our fog color. Simply click here. Select the bitmap. You can either type or you can select it from the other place. I am currently using this texture in my fog color slot to get this result. As far as its stretching is concerned, it's up to you. You can control it in multiple ways. For now, I will just simply click here and I will change my tiling. Again, click here, and you can change your fog multiplier to control its strength. Before I end this tutorial, if you guys are using Vray 5, then remember, in your Vray basic Vray MTL material, you have this presets option. If you click here, then you can simply create a realistic glass, tinted glass. But remember, even if you create this realistic glass or this tinted glass, you will not be able to get your desired results if you don't know the parameters. You still need to change the parameter. So I hope that this tutorial was helpful for you. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love this tutorial, subscribe to my channel, share my videos, keep creating guys, bye bye.